قرآني قرآني في قلبي دوما يغمرني.
سعد بن وقاص رضي الله تعالى عنه, the famous Sahaba. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him. I think all of you have heard this name. Very famous. One of the earliest of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum to join Islam, to join the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, he is amongst the 10 Sahaba that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the glad tidings of Jannah in this dunya, who are known as Ashar al-Mubashirin bil Jannah. The likes of the 4 caliphs, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Sa'd ibn Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhu is one of these 10, a great companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It said that he had a very deep love for his mother. His relationship with his mother was inseparable, nothing seen of its like. And when he embraced Islam, his mother became very bitter about this. And we can imagine, I mean, think about those people who have to become Muslims and their entire families are not in Islam. It gives them a very difficult position and stance. I mean, they choose between their family and the religion and between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a very difficult ultimatum. However, Sa'd radiallahu ta'ala anhu already tasted the sweetness of Iman and he knew this is the truth. And his firm resolve will not make him step back. His mother loved him, and he loved his mother insanely, insanely. So because how loving his mother was to him, and how she loved him, she said to Sa'd, Sa'd, if you do not revoke this religion, I will not eat, I will not drink, I will stay outside the scorching sun of Mecca until one of two things happen. Number one, either I die, number two, you come back. You leave this religion of Muhammad and you come back. Allahu Akbar, what a difficult situation this must have been for Sa'd. He looks at his mother, he kisses her. And he says, Mom, look, I love you. And you know that I love you. Islam is the true religion. I'm not stepping back. Even if you are to have 1,000 souls, and every time one soul was to depart after the other, one after the other, because of you torturing yourself, I would never leave this religion. I will never cease to be a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do as you wish. Her mother did it 1-2 days. She kept on becoming weak, but to no avail, her efforts bore no fruits. She saw that Sa'd is not coming back. She stopped torturing herself. Upon this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a set of verses praising Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وفصاله في عامين أن اشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير وإن جاهداك على أن تشرك بي ما ليس لك به علم فلا تطعهما وصاحبهما في الدنيا معروفا وَصَاحِبَهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا.
Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانِ, we have commanded people, everyone, to be good and kind to their parents. Their mothers carried them with strain upon strain, وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنًا, كُرْهًا عَلَى كُرْهًا, difficulty upon difficulty, and it takes 2 years to wean them. Give thanks to Allah and to your parents, and you should all return to me. You will all return back to me. وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ, and listen, if they strive to make you associate partners with me, that which you have no knowledge about, then you should not obey them. However, keep their company in this life according to what is right. Be gentle and kind to them, and follow the path of those who turn to me. You will all return to me in the end, and I will tell you everything that you have done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering us to be kind, gentle, and to deal with them in the best of ways with our mothers. With the best of ways. But when it comes to them instructing and commanding us to go against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly makes it clear, you should not follow them. Brothers and sisters, look, what do we learn from this? Number one, it's a lesson for those people who became Muslims and they had to sacrifice their family for this. They are trying to be gentle, they're trying to be kind, but it's so difficult because their parents just can't digest the reality. Allahu Akbar. Stay firm. This ayah was not only revealed in praise of Sa'd, it's revealed in praise of everyone who will follow the footsteps of Sa'd ibn Waqqas until the end of times. Number two, as for the remaining of us who were born in Islam and who have our mothers in Islam, when will we stop being rough with our mothers? When will we stop making our mothers cry in the early morning hours? When will we stop, or teenager, or youth, or that person who thinks that he is in the prime of his youth, or an adult who thinks that it is completely fine to raise your voice above the voice of your mother? One of the pious predecessors, his mother called him out, and he responded, he just said, yes, mama, you know, as we say, yeah, mama. And he felt that when he responded to her call, his voice was higher than her call. Allahu Akbar, he thought that he has committed a great sin, and he freed hundreds of slaves in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he couldn't forget himself because of that. One of the pious predecessors, his mom passed away. And at the graveyard, he was crying profusely, uncontrollably, hysterically crying. And the people around him said to him that, she's gone, death is reality. And he said, I know it is a reality, I'm not crying. I'm not crying because my mom has left me, but I'm crying because a direct and an instant door of Jannah has been shut upon me. Our mothers are our instant doors to Jannah. If you have your mother alive, serve her, that's your Jannah. If you don't, be ready to face the consequences. You will suffer in dunya and akhirah. Let's be gentle with our mothers. May Allah make it easy for me and you.